You finally found it. The opportunity of a lifetime. Your friend clued you into a new stock that somehow has risen nearly 1,000% over the course of the year. You're a bit nervous because you wonder if the ship has already sailed, but he tells you that it's not too late to get in and make a killing. You check Twitter and everyone is talking about it. People are posting technical discussions explaining why the company is going to 100x in the next 6 months. They post screenshots of their holdings. One man's $1,000 investment 6 months ago has turned into nearly $1 million today. Everyone is confident that this is a safe investment. Stocks only go up, right? After a few hours of research, the security has risen another 10%. FOMO starts to kick in. If you don't get in now, you'll be missing out on the opportunity of a lifetime. All of your instincts are telling you to buy, buy, buy. So you throw caution to the wind. Take that $10,000 that was sitting in your eTrade account and buy up as many shares as you can. For a short time, this turns out to be an amazing play. Over the course of the next few weeks, you see your investment double. The hype still seems to be strong on social media, so you double down, adding an additional $10,000 investment. You feel like the smartest trader on Wall Street. Suddenly, and without warning, the stock plummets nearly 50%. In your hubris, you forgot to add a stop-loss sell order, and now you've lost over half of your investment. You frantically text your friend, who tells you not to worry. It's just a momentary blip, and the stock is still a fantastic play. You listen, despite your fear. But it turns out that your friend was completely wrong. Over the next few weeks, the stock loses another 50% of its value. All hope is lost, and you decide to cut your losses. You've been duped, tricked into believing the hype of the stock. You'd rather retain a fraction of your investment rather than hold someone else's bags. You were just the victim of the classic pump and dump scheme. Pump and dump schemes are illegal, but that doesn't mean they don't happen all the time. Usually, pump and dumps happen with penny stocks because they have the most room to grow. Basically, how it works is a group of individuals will buy up a significant portion of a security. Then they'll hype it up in online message boards or by onboarding people they know. As more and more people are tricked into believing the hype, the stock price will soar, caused by a restriction of supply but excess demand. This is the key inflection point. When it starts to make massive moves, the stock will be picked up by reputable online news sources, which will report on the gains. This causes even more investors to start looking into the stock and buying in, despite the fundamentals of the company not having changed at all. The reality is that most retail investors don't actually know what they're doing. They rely on emotion to make their trades, instead of actually understanding why a stock is valued the way that it is. So when news sources start reporting on it, many people have fear of missing out. The insiders that own most of the stock will hold on to it as long as the hype seems strong. After all, they want the stock to gain as much as it can before they sell. Slowly, they'll start selling portions of their holdings to cover their initial investment and then some. Eventually, the hype will become so strong that the stock will gain massively in a single day. Investors will flood the stock, hoping to get in on the action. And that's when the insiders will make their move. They will offload as much stock as they can as quickly as they can, hoping to maximize their gains when the stock is at its highest. At this point, there will be enough unwitting retail investors to buy it up. The stock will become incredibly liquid because a massive amount of supply will have been released by the holders. Once this occurs, the supply and demand of the stock will switch places. Instead of having restricted supply and overwhelming demand, there will be overwhelming supply and limited demand. The stock price will fall rapidly as this occurs, because investors who sought to get in and make a quick buck will suddenly see their investments slipping away from them. As more investors start to sell off, the stock price will fall further and further. Those that hold out will become bag holders, having lost most of their investment. One of the most well-known cases of the pump and dump scheme was executed by Jordan Belfort. You may remember the story from the wildly popular movie The Wolf of Wall Street. This happened during the days before the internet, when investment bankers would cold call individuals and get them to purchase stocks over the phone. Belfort was an amazing salesman, and could convince practically anyone that the penny stocks he was hyping up were actually amazing, once-in-a-lifetime investments. Belfort's company, Stratton Oakmont, would engage in other illegal activity to artificially increase the stock price, including refusing to process orders to sell the stock from their investors. Eventually, Belfort was caught and convicted, but he only served 22 months in prison as part of a plea deal, in which he helped investigators uncover more illegal activity from his partners. Another classic example of the pump-and-dump scheme happened with Enron in 2001. Enron executives used many illegal tactics to pump the price of the stock, and 29 members of the company sold stock worth more than $1 billion before the company collapsed. In addition to hyping the stock using their social channels, the executives used illegal accounting practices to falsely report company profits. In order to hide their debt, they created complex financial structures and deals that bewildered even the most seasoned Wall Street professionals. The stock price reached a high of $90.75 and subsequently crashed to $1. In the end, several executives of both Enron and their accounting firm were indicted and convicted of felonies. The employees of Enron only received a fraction of their promised returns, despite losing billions from their pensions. Today, pump and dump schemes are easier to execute than ever before. With the rise of cryptocurrencies, a largely unregulated market that experiences amazing boom and bust cycles, bad actors frequently seek to hype up their coins only to leave unwitting investors in the lurch. Many of these schemes are organized on the encrypted messaging app Telegram, making it difficult for lawmakers to know who is behind the fraud. Additionally, because of the global nature of the market, bad actors can exist anywhere in the world, outside the jurisdiction of investigators. And because of the incredible stories we hear every day about someone becoming a crypto millionaire after only a small investment in a coin, many people see it as worth taking a risk on some speculative coin if the prospective gains are so massive. In the crypto community, these alternative coins are called shitcoins because they offer little to no value in the development of the new blockchain technology and exist only to make the creators of the coin rich. In the ICO boom of 2017, this scheme was all too common. At the time, anyone could spend 20 minutes altering the source code of Ethereum to create an ERC-20 token, publish a bogus white paper about how their coin was going to change the market in some drastic way, and list their coin for an initial coin offering. Investors were willing to take on the risk because the price was so cheap. If even one of their shitcoins became valuable, it would more than make up for the scams that they fell prey to. The result of this is that a significant amount of money was transferred to scammers and criminals. Once they held the bags for these coins, even honest investors would take to social media to promote the coin. After all, how did they know that the hype around it was completely unfounded? Even if the coin ended up being a scam, they had plausible deniability, because they too believed that the coin could change the world. In another example, there are many who believe that the online Wall Street Bets message board has been facilitating pump and dump schemes for popular meme stocks, such as AMC and GameStop. While many who participated in the insane run-up of GameStop to $483 genuinely believe that the stock is undervalued, there were certainly some manipulators who duped others into climbing aboard, knowing full well that the stock would crash. These types of pump and dump schemes make it hard for investigators to indict guilty parties. After all, because the pump and dump wasn't strictly organized by a group of individuals, everyone involved has plausible deniability that they believed the due diligence that was posted. They just liked the stock, right? So now that you know how a pump and dump works, how should you best protect yourself from becoming a bag holder? Here's a few tips. First, avoid jumping on a stock that you hear about through email. Pump and dump schemes are hyper prevalent in email spam, accounting for nearly 15% of spam messages. This might seem like basic advice, but you'd be amazed at how many people actually fall victim to it. Even reputable sources of stock information, such as Seeking Alpha, may unknowingly be contributing to pump and dump schemes. After all, if everyone who sees their email goes out and buys the stock price will inevitably rise and help make someone else rich. Second, be hypercritical of financial advice given to you by friends and family. Even if their intentions are good, these people may be susceptible to online hype and might not fully understand the financials of the companies that they're invested in. If you receive a tip from a friend or family member, make sure to do your own research. Third, avoid FOMO buying. Pump and dump schemes rely on investors using their emotions over their research. Fear of missing out is one of the primary drivers of artificially inflated stock prices. Even Wall Street professionals fall victim to this type of thinking. Remember this classic advice: be fearful when others are greedy. Be greedy when others are fearful. Hey guys, thanks for watching the show. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and we'll see you next week.